डायरेक्ट, व्हाट इज डायरेक्ट स्पीच, व्हाट आई एम सेइंग दैट इज डायरेक्ट. ओके, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. दिस इज डायरेक्ट स्पीच. व्हेन यू गो आउटसाइड एंड टेल समबडी, मैम टोल्ड अस दैट शी वुड डू डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच, दैट विल बिकम इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. मैम आई कैन फिक्स इट, भवनेश सेड. What is it? Yes. Ma'am, I can fix it. So, what is it? This is direct speech. बाद में कर देना. Thank you, Shukumar. So Dhavnesh said, "Ma'am, I can fix it." So this is a direct speech because it is as it is. What Dhavnesh said. So when you go home, what will you tell your parents? Yeah, then it will be. The whole blackboard is not coming. So Dhavnesh addressed his teacher respectfully and said that he could fix that thing. Got it? So what's here? Ma'am has been changed into addressing somebody respectfully. Ma'am is not somebody's name. It's a title. When you say sir or ma'am to anyone, you are addressing that person respectfully. Okay? Ma'am is not my adjective. It's only the way you address somebody when you give respect to somebody. Okay? Sir or ma'am are not always the teachers. Okay? Anyone whom you give respect, that is like this. So Dhavnesh addressed his teacher respectfully and said that he could fix that thing. Okay? Any doubt here? So when we did this direct to indirect form, then we kept in mind a few things. First thing, it was the reporting verb. Addressed over here is reporting verb. Instead of said, I have written over here, addressed his teacher. Then afterwards, even the said is reporting verb. So these are in past tense. Why I used past tense? Because in the direct form, it was indirect. In the direct form, it was past. So you will also retain the past form in your answers. Second thing, the inverted commas have changed into that. Okay, instead of inverted commas, you have put that because the given sentence was a statement. That was an assertive sentence. That was a statement like, I can fix it. I can. It is starting with a subject, then verb, then object. So it was a simple assertive sentence. When there is an assertive sentence or a negative sentence, we use that as a linker. So after then, when the word ma'am was there, it means that it was a person who was addressed. So you mentioned it, that he addressed his teacher respectfully. Respectfully is because of the word ma'am. Okay? Had it been like teacher? Teacher, I can fix it. Then what could you have said? Dhavnesh told his teacher that he could repair that. Got it? So ma'am because of ma'am, it has addressed his teacher respectfully. Had it been the word teacher itself, he told teacher that. Okay, so that is because of the inverted commas. After the inverted commas, there is assertive sentence. And afterwards, you know, I can fix it. So subject changes according to the, when you get a subject in the reporting speech, you change it according to the subject of reporting verb. What is a reporting verb? Reporting verb is from where we come to know who said to whom. Okay, here reporting verb is said. Reporting verb. Dhavnesh said. Said is a reporting verb. So here with reporting verb, the subject is Dhavnesh and teacher or ma'am is object. Got it? Dhavnesh told teacher. So teacher is object and subject is that thing. So when I comes here, when subject is in the first person, in the reporting speech, the subject changes according to the, I changes according to the subject of reporting verb. I is Dhavnesh and who is Dhavnesh? Dhavnesh is he. Neither I am Dhavnesh. When you are talking to somebody about this thing, you are also not Dhavnesh. Right? So what will you say? Dhavnesh told his teacher respectfully that he, okay, he. So I has become he because I is Dhavnesh. And Dhavnesh is third person. And third person will become he. That he, now it is can. So if the reporting verb is past, then the verb in the reporting speech also changes to past. If the reporting verb in the present, if the reporting verb is past, then the verb in reporting speech also changes to past. But that rule is from present to past and past to past perfect. What's the rule of reporting speech? Past changes to, let's see, first say talk about present. Present changes to past. And past changes to past perfect. That's the only rule you need to learn regarding tenses. And this covers up all the rules of tenses in narration. Present means maybe present indefinite, maybe present continuous, maybe present perfect. So whatever tense in present, it changes to past. But it should be the corresponding tense. If it is present indefinite will change into past indefinite. If it is present perfect, it will change into past perfect. If it is present continuous, it will change into past continuous. Okay, corresponding tense you will change it into. Present changes to past. If it is present indefinite, it will change into, yes, past indefinite. If it is present continuous, it will change into past continuous. If it is present perfect, it will change into past perfect. You don't need to learn these rules separately, because the rule in narration says that if the reporting verb is in past tense, the verb of reporting speech changes from present to past and past to past perfect. Now look at the verb. It is can. Can is what? First form of verb, and the second form will means the past form. So can will become could. So that he could. Could, because can has changed into second form. That he could fix. With can we use V1. With could also we use V1. And it or this changes to that. It or this changes to that. So it will become that. What that? You can't finish your sentence like this. That thing, that plug, okay? That object, that work, whatever. So complete it. Is that clear? So with it, the sentence was complete, but with that, it's not complete. So that thing, that object, that plug, that switchboard, whatever, right? So it was one example of like things we are to keep in mind when we are changing the narration. I've given you the golden rule of narration. What is that golden rule of narration, Divita? Divita is telling me the golden rule is that present tends to past and past tends to past perfect, but it is incomplete. What's the full golden rule? After past perfect, no change. Yeah, that's right. After past perfect, there is no change. Past perfect is the last one. Okay, you cannot go from past. You can go from present to past, and from past you can go to past perfect, but beyond that you cannot go. Okay, human being has his own limitations. Okay. So point is, present changes to past and past changes to past perfect, but there is one, something is incomplete. What's that? Who will complete? It's a golden rule. This much you first change. This much you tell me, like, what is incomplete about present changes to past and past changes to past perfect? Past perfect doesn't change. That's it. Finish. So maybe it is perfect, past perfect continuous or something else. That is, like I've already told you, like this is the golden rule. Golden rule may have its sub rules. Sub rules are there, but when you know the golden rule, those sub rules will, you will automatically know. But what is incomplete about this rule is that you have to also say this, that when the reporting verb is in past, then this golden rule is applicable. Otherwise, this rule doesn't apply. If I say Dhavnesh says, comma inverted comma start, then this rule is not required. Dhavnesh says that, or Dhavnesh says, or Dhavnesh addresses his teacher respectfully and says that he can fix the problem. So that rule will be, can will remain can, then no change in tense. So this can is becoming good because it was passed over here. It was said. That's why. When the reporting verb is in past, then verb in reporting speech changes from present to past and past to past perfect. But if the reporting verb is in present or future, what I'm saying, repeat with me. When it is says or will say, then verb of reporting speech does not change. Then the tense of reporting speech doesn't change. Whatever, become relaxed. Tense will not change. Okay? So for accordingly, write some examples to relate to this golden rule. So now the complete golden rule is, I'm saying one thing, one time, then all of you will okay. So the complete golden rule is, when the reporting verb is in past tense, the tense of reporting speech changes. That is, present becomes past and past becomes past perfect. But if the reporting verb is present or future, the tense of reporting speech doesn't change. Right? Another golden rule that you all know already, but when the reporting speech is a universal fact, when the reporting speech is a universal fact or a scientific fact. Then also the tense of reporting speech doesn't change in any case if the reporting speech is a universal truth or a scientific fact. Then the tense of reporting speech doesn't change in any case, even if it is reporting speech, reporting verb is past, even then it doesn't change. Got it? Accordingly, let me give you one example. You people apply your mind, then write. Write on. My grandmother said to me, my grandmother said to me, my grandmother said to me, what should we say? My grandmother said to me, God is one. Right on. My grandmother said, so first of all, let's see, like, what kind of sentences God is one? It's a fact. It's a fact. It's a truth. It's not that your grandmother says this, then it is this thing, and when I will say something, then it will become past. So it's a fact. So here the tense will not change. Although here it is reporting verb is past. Even when the reporting verb is past, then the fact doesn't change. My grandmother told me that God is one. Okay? Next sentence, write on one more. I said to my grandmother, God cannot be one. Because he is in various forms. Because he is in various forms like Ram, Rahim or Vaheguru. Like Ram, Rahim or Vaheguru. Okay, now change the narration. Anji Khushi, what did you say? Yes, speak the answer. Yes, correct answer. So have you all children written over here? Let me ask these children. Yes, Harshdeep, all of you children, turn on your videos and let me see your work. Show me your notebooks. I'm giving you all 1 minute and turn on your videos and show me your work, all of you. The children, those who are here in the class, see their work. See, it takes 1 minute to show their work. See? So those here who are online, let us see whether they've also written this much or not. Okay, hurry up, come on, turn on your videos. So no one is turning on the video. Tanushka, you do it first. Yes, Prabhun, turn on your video. Yes.
Now my camera is giving problem. It is not allowing it.
Actually, I have turned it off. Okay, now you do. Yes. Now you can turn on your videos. Yes, Ms. T. Okay. It's okay. Mute yourself. Yes, Raghun, it's okay. Though I couldn't see your notebook. Yes. The point was, I told my grandmother. My grandmother told me that God is one, but I was not convinced, and told her that and told my grandmother that it was not possible, because God was there in various forms, and because we call him as this or this. So who is right? Grandmother is right or you are right? Yeah. Okay. So then, now grandmother. Grandmother said to me, what are the names by which your parents call you? My grandmother said to me, comma, inverted comma, start. What are the names by which your parents call you? What are the names by which your parents call you? What are the names by which your parents call you? What will you say? Okay, my grandmother asked me, by what names my parents called me. No, that is about, I'll tell you, like, then it becomes from complex to simple sentence. Okay. We'll discuss that in different lecture. So my grandmother asked me by what names my parents called me. By what names my parents used to call me. I said to my grandmother, yes, anyone who has got three names, stand up. Anyone who is called as called by three names at home. One, you have got one name in the school. Two more names if you have, stand up and tell us. No one will tell us? Okay, then write down imaginary names. So, yes. Okay, write down. I said to my grandmother, Simar, Simu, and Sira. Right? It could be anyone's names. Okay, Gunnu, Simar, and Sira. Full stop and commas closed. Now change its narration. Tanushka will give the answer now. Tanushka, yes. Jap Jot. Jap Jot. Okay, Prabhnoor. Prabhnoor. Gursevak. Gursevak, unmute yourself. Okay, Simarleen. Okay, so here no one is. Yes. Yes, last boy, give the answer. Wrong. Where is the reporting speech? Where is the verb of the reporting speech? Can the reporting speech be without verbs? No. So first you complete that. I told my grandmother that I was called by, that my parents call me as this, this or this. I told my grandmother that my parents called me as this, this or this. Got it? So you have to complete the reporting speech. Reporting speech should have a subject and verb and object. Sit down. Okay, now next sentence. Now write down the rules, children. So is this clear? Like when the reporting verb is in present, reporting speech, the tense changes. And inside tense, they are also clear, like present indefinite changes to past indefinite, present continuous changes to past continuous, present perfect changes to past perfect, and present perfect changes to past perfect, present perfect continuous changes to past perfect continuous. So related to this, write some example. My teacher said to me, my teacher said to me, this class always performs well in the exams. This class always performs well in the exams. Yes. Yes. So here, this class always performs. What is performs? Present indefinite. And present indefinite will change into past indefinite, that is performed. Rest of the things, my teacher told me that class always performed well in the exams. Okay, performs has changed into performed. Okay, the other changes, like this has become that. Okay, and said has turned into told. Next sentence. Why aren't you working hard to get good marks? Said my father. Why aren't you working hard to get good marks? Why aren't you working hard why aren't you working hard said my father so why aren't you working hard said my father what's the reporting verb here What's the reporting verb here? Raise hand. What's the reporting verb here? Yes, Imani? Aditi, yes, Aditi. Yeah, said is the reporting verb. right? And this area is the reporting. This is subject of the reporting verb. And who is the object of this reporting verb? Father is a subject. Who is the object? Yeah, I am the object, because I am being talked to. Okay, said my father. So what it will become, and remember, it's an interrogative sentence. It's an interrogative sentence. So when the interrogative sentence comes, it means that you have to make it assertive. Assertive means you have to make it a statement. It should not remain a question now. And you have to change the tense also, because said, past. And which tense is here? Are you working? Which tense? It is present continuous. So present continuous will become past continuous. If you remember only the simple rule, present becomes past. So is MR will change into was or were. Rest of the things would remain the same. So what it will become? My father asked me. Okay, answer. Now see. My father asked me, why was I not working hard? Is it okay? Is it okay? Yes. So the mistake is why I was. Because when you write an interrogative sentence, then verb comes first. The way here it was, why aren't you? Verb is first, then object is coming. But when you're writing an assertive sentence, then first subject comes, then verb. Why I was not working hard. Very minor thing, but very important. In exams, in the MCQ forms, you'll be getting these kinds of mistakes. Okay, those who don't know this minor thing, they will say like everything is fine with both of the sentences. Okay, so first subject, then verb. Okay, now write down next sentence. She said, how will you do this? She said, how will you do this? She said, how will you do this, Manav? Question mark. How will you do this, Manav? How? How? Yes. Correct. So she asked Manav how he would do that. Will become would, and moreover subject will come first. How he would do that. Full stop.